What is up, guys? Razor here. Welcome back to Dot Hack Part 2 Mutation. In the previous episode, we went to a dungeon and met with Wiseman, who has information for us. Let's check the inbox. It better be in there. There it is, Wiseman. Alright, so we also got an email from Marlo here. Marlo's character. Your character is so cool, kind of like a dark, brooding hero. I like it. You do? It's weird, but thanks. I like it too. And for this email, we'll reply with, actually, when I first saw you, I thought you were the enemy. Yeah, because he looks all evil and stuff. Alright, here's the email from Wiseman that we've been seeking. You will get right to the point. The Spark Sword is somewhere in Blooming Promise Walkway. I will exchange information about the Epitaph of Twilight for it. Okay. So that's our next destination. We'll put Nuke in our party. Let's see, who else I want to bring. Can't bring Mia, it won't let us. She's away. Same for Elk. We'll bring Mistral. Blooming Promise Walkway, wood area, level 44. Oh, I gotta put Black Rose, darn it. Okay, another protected area. We got a gate hack. Should have plenty of them. Ooh, just enough Fs. Need to get some more Fs, I guess. You get Fs from large enemies. Need to farm some more of those, I guess.
The Spark Sword is in this dungeon.
Temple Knight, new enemy here. And apparently they hit pretty hard. Six side blade. Two Temple Knights. Oh, they're magic tolerant. Mazamune armor. That's a pretty good armor there. Six side blades for Blade Master. I'll throw the six side blade in there since I have two of them. Lion's Blade. See, I went two levels higher. Where's the Mandragora at? There they are. Should have a lot of those. Let's see how many of those I have. 61. You never have too many of those, though. Nope, can't do that drain. Alright, so I'll clear out one more magic portal and that'll be it for this. And I'll resume the video after I clear out all the magic portals. Okay, this one doesn't count since it was just a chest. Bone armor. Can sell that. Alright, I'm going to clear all the rest of the magic portals in the field. And I'll meet you guys at the dungeon. Be right back. Alright, so I cleared all the magic portals in the field. Let's enter the dungeon now. This is like a big dungeon again. More temple knights. Oh, I lost the XP, wow. Alright, leveled up. So I got my level back. Nice, leveled up. Alright, let's continue on here. We go down this way. Fight two more sets of enemies. I want to get rid of the mages first. We go, and I'll bring back Mistral there. Take out the Temple Knight. These Temple Knights do a lot of damage, but it's not so bad. I have a lot of evasion, so I can evade some of their attacks. Ooh, a lot of chests down here. Gotta use a fortune wire. I need to buy more of those too, I think, don't I? No, I don't. I already did. Resurrect. Another fortune wire there. Another resurrect. Alright, let's go back this way. Work our way around the other side. Come here. Quit trying to run. Get the egg. Thank you. Speed charm wore off. Oh, it's a new enemy there. Big eyes. Susceptible to magic. Okay. Continue on here. Threat to the mage. Oh crap, it's immune to thunder, dang it. Need data drain. Virus core E. Immature egg. All right, down to the second floor. A cage or cell over there. Never seen that before in a dungeon. That's cool. Let me buff up a little bit here. Recovery drink, nice. Give me all the recovery drinks. I'll take them all. Ebony armor. Already have that, I think, in the storage. Okay, Iron Ball Titan, new enemy. Susceptible to magic. Like pretty much every big enemy in the game. Now these things, not so much. Nice critical hit there. How good are we doing on levels? 46, 46. More than, almost 47. We have to use another speed charm here. Or no, it's still active. Never mind. Thought it wore off. Okay, fortune wire. Jet bracer. And down to the next floor. And no chest there, it doesn't look like it. Nope, no chest. Sometimes I'll put chest before you go down. That never happened in infection, but it happens in mutation. But yeah, you never get chest at the beginning of floors or the end of floors in infection, just only a mutation. I think in the later games too, but I'm not sure. But I know for a fact in this game you get them at the beginning of floors and sometimes at the end of floors. Okay, looks like the boss battle's up ahead. Which means you want to buff up before continuing here. Okay, and for Mistral we want Knight, Hermit Blood, Beast Blood, and Magical Accuracy with the Wizard Blood. There we go. So we're all buffed up, ready to go. And it's boss time against I have no clue. Can't really Grogon, maybe? Not really sure. I guess I'll figure it out as soon as we gotta drain it. Make sure to stay above 500 hit points because it hits pretty hard. Yeah, that's like that. That attacked us a lot. You want to kind of separate from Black Rose as well. Forgot to have her cast spells. Okay, virus core. Oh. Virus Core O. Oh, Beligon. Beligon's its name. Against this enemy, you need, like, fire resistance. There we go, got it. And after you defeat it, you get the Spark Sword. So a fairly easy boss, so this does a ton of damage. You gotta watch out for that flame attack. If you have fire resistance, that would help a lot. But other than that, pretty easy. Still where? We go back to that other dungeon? Oh, okay, here we go.
Huh? Ball monk?
What's he doing here?
Do you understand? Give this to...
And they disappear. Or they teleport away, I mean. Start storing some stuff again. And sell everything else. I think I might hold on to the lubbers. That's actually a pretty good item to use. I'm actually hold on to those. Let me store my holy saps. Yeah, we have to go back here. Alright, we'll do that in the next episode. So thank you guys for watching. Stay tuned for the next episode. And later.